My favorite topic today.
Running.
I get to talk about running.
Yes.
Out on the patio with one of my favorite people. We'll get to her in just a minute, but people are starting to gear up for the running season because there are a lot of really great races in Northern California. One of the biggest is, of course, the California International Marathon, the 30th CIM coming up the first Sunday in December. A lot of people getting ready for that, starting to build their base miles. And Suzanne Cardenas, may I brag about your running?
Oh, sure.
She's an ultra runner, which means she runs crazy long distances. She's phenomenal.
Thank you.
Great runner. And don't, I mean, are you like this too, where you just get so excited with people starting to get out on the trails?
Oh, the cooler temperatures. I mean, I miss the extra daylight, but the cooler temperatures, it just makes you want to run and just run as long as you can.
So, Which is really the key for a lot of people if you're hoping to take on maybe one of the half marathons coming up this fall. The thing is, just running is not enough. We know a lot more about it now.
Yeah, and again, we like to go out. We like to go out really and run, and we get a lot of extra kind of junk miles that we don't really need. So there's a couple of things you can do to kind of, as you're ramping up your miles, so that way you have a really good race and you stay injury free as well. So just, you know, very short, very simple, because again, we as runners, we like to spend time running. But if you're new too, there's some things you just want to think about that you're like, oh, I just thought I'd go out to run. You know, it's so simple just to go run, but there's a lot of stuff that goes into it.
So let's talk about some of these moves. One of them incorporates the BOSU.
Okay, so it's a BOSU, and she's just doing a kind of just stagger, so she's just loading the legs a little bit different. I'm going to ask Erin to go to a one leg squat, because what happens is one leg tends to be a little bit stronger than another. Go into one leg.
Does it tend to be the side that you're
on the ground?
You're dominant on anyway?
You know, it's interesting. It's always an adventure for me to find out what leg is stronger. So she's having to work her ankle and knee stabilizers as well and get her balance. But, you know, you want to go into it balanced. You know, do you always lead up that hill with your right foot or is it your left foot? And kind of balance that out. So that's just one of the exercises. Then she can go ahead and stand on the BOSU. Again, this is just something, again, maybe you're running with road races. Again, the road's really nice and smooth. But what if you step on a rock or a pothole or whatever? So she's going to stand on one leg. And really, again, she's engaging a little bit deeper into those muscle fibers because she's on an unstable surface. And then she's having the hip abduction. So she can take the leg out and in. So she's going to touch to give her that point of balance. And again, this is going to strengthen her core. And her joint stabilizers as well.
How many reps are you going to do with these?
Whatever you can do safely, you're going to start to feel your knee and ankle, and they're going to start to fatigue, so then you want to stop. I mean, we want to build up to about 15, maybe 20.
Okay.
But again, do what you can safely. If you can't find your balance, then, you know, step off and then do the other side and then maybe come back and do another set. And then I'm going to have Erin come on off, and she's going to do just some crunches. Again, I like the BOSU just because it is unstable, so you're going to work a little bit deeper into those muscle fibers, but
you can do it. It's a little harder to cheat when you have it, too, I think.
It is harder to cheat. You got to really be thoughtful and think about your core and think about the muscles, and those muscles support you, so when you're running, you're starting to get tired and fatigued, you still have good form. So, again, something I try to come up with, something very simple so it doesn't take away from your running, but adds to your experience, adds to your training. And just to make it a little more fun,
because that's kind of how fun, you are.
She's going to hold that and bring her legs up, and this is, I mean, it looks easy, but you feel your abs, and then she's going to extend one leg out and the other adding the bicycles.
Okay, she is strong.
And then she's going to add a rotation. She is strong. And she's getting ready for the first CIM, too.
That's awesome.
She had an MCL injury, and we've worked on her knee and strengthened her up, and now she's getting ready to run her first marathon.
That's awesome, Erin. This is going to be great. You're picking a great one to start for your first one. Thanks for coming in. I love just the whole idea of trying to make your workout smarter, because who wants to waste their time and then get hurt?
So just that 1 mile that you didn't need to do, don't do that. Do some of these, and you'll feel a huge difference. You'll
Good
feel the return.
All right, thanks. You can see Workout Wednesday segments at thenewkcra.com.